Welcome to FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. Shadows of the Paris Antique Shop. Chapter 1. The Vanishing Ring. The antique shop is nestled in a quaint corner of Montmartre, like a silent guardian of time's secrets. Its facade, adorned with ivy and age-worn wood, exuded an air of mystery that drew the curious souls wandering the cobblestone streets. The bell above the door, tarnished with the passage of countless seasons, announced each visitor with a delicate chime that resonated within the walls, a subtle melody echoing tales untold. As Detective Eloise Duval crossed the threshold into this enclave of antiquities, a sense of reverence filled the air. Monsieur Leclerc, the proprietor with a demeanor as enigmatic as the artifacts he curated, emerged from the shadows, a guardian of stories waiting to be unraveled. Detective Duval, Monsieur Leclerc greeted with a nod, his eyes reflecting both gratitude and apprehension. The antiquariat, with its shelves laden with time-worn books, ancient manuscripts, and artifacts from epochs long past, awaited Eloise's discerning eye. Guided to the heart of the shop, Eloise found herself standing before a display case that once cradled a precious heirloom, a ring with a lineage entwined with the annals of Montmartre's history. The velvet lining bore the imprint of the missing relic, a void in the tableau of carefully arranged artifacts. "Tell me about the ring, Monsieur Leclerc," Eloise urged, her voice a gentle caress, coaxing forth the narratives that lingered in the shop's very foundation. Monsieur Leclerc's eyes, reminiscent of faded constellations, betrayed a mixture of sorrow and nostalgia. "This ring, detective, is not merely a trinket. It carries the essence of a love story that defied the constraints of its time, a Leclerc legacy passed through generations." As the antiquarian began to unfurl the tapestry of the ring's saga, Eloise sensed the shop transforming into a sanctuary of memories. The ring, once worn by a spirited Leclerc ancestor named Isabel, bore witness to a love that transcended societal norms. Isabel, with her heart untamed, fell in love with a kindred spirit from a different world, Monsieur Leclerc continued, his voice a melodic whisper woven with echoes of the past. Their love, forbidden by the rigid codes of their era, became a clandestine flame burning beneath the surface of Montmartre's bohemian allure. Eloise's gaze fixated on the empty velvet cradle, as if the void itself whispered the secrets it once held. The missing ring, a tangible relic of love and defiance, became a vessel for the tales that lingered within the antiquariat's walls. With each word, Monsieur Leclerc painted a vivid canvas of Montmartre in a bygone era, a realm of artists, intellectuals, and rebels who defied convention. Isabel's story unfolded against the backdrop of dimly lit cafes, clandestine meetings, and the palpable tension that coursed through the quarter's narrow streets. As the tale reached its zenith, with Isabel's forbidden love teetering on the edge of revelation, the ring vanished, leaving an indelible void in the Leclerc chronicles. The detective, now immersed in the story, felt the weight of responsibility to unearth the truth hidden within the folds of time. Eloise emerged from the antiquariat into the fading daylight, the story of the Leclercs echoing in her mind. The streets of Montmartre, bathed in hues of amber, became a tapestry of possibilities. The detective, armed with the resonance of the past, embarked on a journey to trace Isabel's footsteps through the labyrinth and alleys. As the first stars punctuated the evening sky, Eloise found herself standing before the historic mansion that once housed the Leclercs. Its weathered facade held the whispers of forgotten secrets, a silent witness to the tumultuous love that had unfolded within its walls. The detective ascended the grand staircase, the creaking steps beneath her echoing the heartbeat of the mansion. In an abandoned room, she discovered a trove of forgotten relics, a collection of artifacts and mementos, each telling a chapter of the Leclerc saga. There, nestled within an ornate jewelry box, Eloise uncovered the missing ring. Its reappearance signaled not just the end of a quest, but the revival of a story long relegated to the recesses of history. As she cradled the ring in her hands, the echoes of Isabel's love reverberated through the mansion, harmonizing with the whispers of Montmartre. The detective descended the staircase, the ring now both a key and a bridge to the Leclercs' untold stories. Montmartre, with its labyrinth of alleys and hidden tales, became the stage for the next act in a saga that had endured through time, a saga that Detective Eloise Duval was determined to unveil. Chapter 2. Shadows of Montmartre's Past. As Detective Eloise Duval delved deeper into the heart of Montmartre, the city revealed its secrets layer by layer. The narrow streets, adorned with flickering gas lamps, beckoned her with a promise of unraveling mysteries. With the missing ring safely secured in her pocket, Eloise navigated through the bohemian labyrinth, each step echoing with the resonance of a bygone era. Montmartre's nocturnal allure intensified as the moon ascended, casting shadows that danced along the cobblestones. The antiquariat, now a distant landmark, seemed to pulse with the energy of the Leclercs' history, urging the detective to decipher the enigma that surrounded Isabel's forbidden love. Guided by whispers of the past, Eloise's journey led her to a dimly lit bookstore tucked away in an obscure corner of Montmartre. The time-worn shelves cradled volumes that seemed to hold the city's secrets, a literary trove waiting to be explored. As the detective entered, the scent of aged paper enveloped her, and the ambient glow of antique lamps cast an ethereal ambience. The bookseller, an elderly gentleman with spectacles perched on his nose, greeted Eloise with a knowing smile. "Detective Duval, you seek tales that transcend time, do you not?" His words carried the weight of someone who had witnessed the ebb and flow of Montmartre's narratives. With a nod, Eloise explained her quest, the missing ring, and the echoes of Isabel's love story. The bookseller, well-versed in the city's clandestine tales, guided her to a section reserved for manuscripts that spoke of secret societies and hidden passages beneath the streets. One particular tome, its leather cover weathered by years of existence, caught Eloise's attention. Its title, Whispers of the Bohemian Underground, hinted at a world concealed beneath the glamorous surface of Montmartre's artistic fervor. The detective delicately turned the pages, revealing accounts of covert meetings, masked balls, and a clandestine society that flourished in the shadows. Cryptic notes in the margins pointed toward connections between Isabel's love and the mysterious organization. Eloise, captivated by the revelations unfolding before her, felt the tendrils of a conspiracy reaching across time. As she absorbed the information, the bookseller offered a cryptic piece of advice. The answers lay not only in the words, but in the echoes of Montmartre itself. Armed with newfound knowledge, Eloise stepped back into the moonlit streets, her path now illuminated by the enigmatic threads of the city's history. Montmartre, with its hidden passages and clandestine tales, became a tableau awaiting the detective's exploration. The detective's next destination emerged from the whispers of an old painter she encountered in a dimly lit cafe. His canvas bore the strokes of untold stories, capturing the essence of Montmartre's eternal romance. The artist spoke of Isabel's love, of meetings in secluded gardens, and the shadows that concealed a forbidden affair. As Eloise navigated toward the artist's described location, she found herself standing before an ancient mansion, a forgotten relic hidden behind vines and thyme. The mansion, a silent witness to Montmartre's secrets, harbored the echoes of Isabel's footsteps. The detective entered cautiously, the air heavy with the scent of antiquity. The mansion's abandoned rooms whispered tales of grandeur and decay. In a forgotten chamber at the heart of the mansion, Eloise discovered a collection of family heirlooms, each narrating a chapter of the Leclerc's legacy. Among the relics, a faded portrait of Isabel stood as a poignant reminder of the love that defied societal norms. The detective's gaze shifted to an ornate jewelry box, the same box where the missing ring had once resided. Eloise's heart quickened as she opened the box, revealing the ring gleaming in the dim light. The significance of its discovery resonated through the mansion, as if the very walls sighed in recognition. With the ring now in her possession, Eloise felt a sense of closure, yet the mysteries of Montmartre continued to unfold like a captivating tapestry. As she descended the grand staircase of the mansion, the moonlight filtered through the dusty windows, casting an ethereal glow on the detective's path. Montmartre, with its secrets bared, awaited the final act in the unraveling tale of Isabel's love, a tale that transcended the boundaries of time, echoing through the labyrinthine alleys and hidden corners of the Bohemian enclave. Chapter 3. Echoes in the Bohemian Wind. Montmartre, with its cobbled streets steeped in history, unfolded before Detective Eloise Duval like a canvas eager to share its secrets. The discovery of the missing ring had become a key, unlocking not only the mysteries surrounding Isabel's forbidden love, but also revealing the intricate tapestry of a clandestine society that thrived beneath the bohemian allure of the quarter. As the detective continued her exploration, guided by the whispers of the past, she found herself drawn to an artist's studio tucked away in an obscure corner of Montmartre. The aroma of turpentine and the vibrant hues of half-finished canvases greeted her as she entered. The artist, a solitary figure immersed in his work, acknowledged her presence with a nod. Detective Duval explained her quest, the missing ring, and the cryptic notes that hinted at a connection between Isabel's love story and a clandestine society. The artist, sensing the weight of history in the air, set aside his brushes and invited Eloise to delve into the secrets that Montmartre held. On the studio walls, the paintings narrated tales of clandestine meetings, masked balls, and shadowy figures that moved through the quarter's hidden passages. The artist spoke of a society that transcended the boundaries of conventional time, weaving its influence through the threads of history. Among the paintings, one depicted a garden bathed in moonlight, a secret meeting place where Isabel and her forbidden love found solace. The artist described the garden's location, hidden behind the veil of overgrown vines, a sanctuary for those who dared to defy societal norms. Eloise, fueled by determination, ventured into the nocturnal embrace of Montmartre, guided by the artist's descriptions. The cobblestone streets seemed to come alive with whispers as she approached the secluded garden. Moonlight filtered through the tangled foliage, revealing a hidden alcove where Isabel's love story had unfolded. In the stillness of the night, Detective Duval sensed the echoes of the past lingering in the air. The garden, with its overgrown charm, became a stage for the clandestine acts of a society that defied the constraints of its time. The detective examined the surroundings, searching for clues that would further unravel the enigma. As Eloise explored the hidden garden, her fingers brushed against an ancient stone, a concealed entrance that led to a subterranean world beneath Montmartre. The detective descended into the depths, where dimly lit passages revealed the remnants of a clandestine society that once thrived in the shadows. The subterranean labyrinth unfolded like a forgotten chapter of Montmartre's history. The walls bore witness to clandestine gatherings, the air thick with the scent of age-old secrets. Eloise, now immersed in the heart of the society's lair, deciphered inscriptions on the walls that hinted at rituals and alliances forged in secrecy. In an expansive chamber adorned with faded tapestries, she discovered a table surrounded by ornate masks, an emblem of the society's commitment to anonymity. Each mask seemed to carry the weight of untold stories, a silent testament to the bohemian spirits who had dared to challenge societal norms. As Eloise examined the artifacts within the chamber, a revelation struck. The missing ring, a symbol of Isabel's love, held a significance beyond its romantic allure. It was a token of allegiance to the clandestine society, a key that connected the Leclercs to a world hidden beneath Montmartre's glamorous facade. With the ring in hand, Detective Duval retraced her steps through the subterranean passages. The echoes of the clandestine society seemed to resonate in the air, and as she emerged into the moonlit night, Montmartre itself became a witness to the detective's revelations. The artist awaited her return in his studio, his eyes reflecting an understanding of the secrets unveiled. Eloise shared her discoveries, the hidden garden, the subterranean passages, and the connection between Isabel's love story and the clandestine society. The artist nodded, acknowledging that the threads of Montmartre's history were intricately woven, and the missing ring had been a guide through its labyrinth. Armed with newfound knowledge, Detective Eloise Duval stood on the threshold of the final act in the unraveling tale, one that promised to expose the society's secrets and bring closure to Isabel's enigmatic love story. Montmartre, with its bohemian winds carrying echoes of a bygone era, awaited the detective's next move in this captivating dance with history. Chapter 4. The Bohemian Symphony. The moon hung like a celestial lantern over Montmartre as Detective Eloise Duval stood at the crossroads of history and revelation. Armed with the missing ring and the knowledge of Montmartre's clandestine society, she prepared to unravel the final chapters of Isabel's love story, an odyssey that echoed through time. As Detective Duval retraced her steps through the nocturnal streets, the antiquariat emerged in the distance, a silent sentinel guarding the secrets it held within. Monsieur Leclerc awaited her return, his eyes reflecting both anticipation and trepidation. The detective entered the antiquariat, the bell above the door echoing with a resonance that seemed to acknowledge the weight of the revelations yet to unfold. Monsieur Leclerc, Eloise began, her voice steady, the missing ring is not merely a relic of Isabel's love. It is a key to a world beneath Montmartre, a society that defied the norms of its time. Monsieur Leclerc's gaze, as if piercing through the veils of time, conveyed a comprehension of the intricate tapestry woven by the Leclercs and the clandestine society. The antiquarian nodded, inviting Eloise to share the culmination of her discoveries. Seated amidst the shelves of ancient tomes and artifacts, Detective Duval unfolded the tale of the hidden garden, the subterranean passages, and the society that had shaped Montmartre's bohemian spirit. The missing ring, once a symbol of love, now represented a pact between the Leclercs and the clandestine world, a pact that transcended the boundaries of conventional time. Monsieur Leclerc listened intently, his eyes reflecting a mixture of nostalgia and revelation. Isabel's love was a melody in the symphony of Montmartre, he mused, and the clandestine society, its secret refrain. The antiquarian then revealed an aged manuscript, a family chronicle that chronicled the Leclerc's entanglement with the society through generations. The detective perused the pages, each line narrating the Leclerc's role as custodians of the clandestine legacy, a duty passed down from ancestor to descendant. With the manuscript in hand, Eloise and Monsieur Leclerc embarked on a journey through Montmartre's hidden passages. The antiquarian guided her to a forgotten entrance, an ancient door concealed behind layers of ivy. As they descended into the subterranean labyrinth, the air thickened with the anticipation of the revelations yet to be unveiled. In the heart of the clandestine society's lair, Eloise and Monsieur Leclerc discovered a chamber adorned with artifacts and symbols that resonated with a bohemian mystique. The masked figures, rendered in timeless tapestries, seemed to watch over the detective as she approached an altar, a focal point of the society's rituals. Placed upon the altar, surrounded by flickering candlelight, Eloise carefully positioned the missing ring. The chamber seemed to come alive with a subtle energy, as if acknowledging the return of a long-lost relic. A hidden door creaked open, revealing a passage that led even deeper into Montmartre's secrets. Monsieur Leclerc gestured for Eloise to proceed, his eyes conveying gratitude and acknowledgement. The detective descended further into the unknown, guided by the echoes of Isabel's love story and the clandestine society's enigmatic presence. In the subterranean depths, Eloise discovered a vast chamber adorned with murals that depicted the Leclerc's intertwined fate with the bohemian society. The missing ring, now a centerpiece, became a beacon illuminating the shared history of love, defiance, and the unspoken bonds that connected Montmartre's souls. As Detective Eloise Duval emerged from the hidden passages, she found herself standing in a cavernous space beneath Montmartre, the city's heartbeat echoing through the stone walls. Monsieur Leclerc joined her, and together they gazed upon the murals that told a story beyond the confines of time. Montmartre, with its hidden passages and clandestine societies, revealed itself as a living canvas, an evolving masterpiece that continued to captivate and mystify. Detective Duval, having unraveled the secrets of Isabel's love and the Leclerc's connection to the Bohemian Symphony, felt a profound sense of completion. As they ascended into the moonlit night, the antiquariat awaited, a repository of Montmartre's tales guarded by Monsieur Leclerc and the detective. The missing ring, returned to its place within the Leclerc legacy, became not just a relic but a testament to the enduring spirit of love and defiance that echoed through the bohemian winds of Montmartre, a symphony that transcended the boundaries of time.